Hari Om, started the prayer. Om Samasta Jana Kalyani Niratam Karunamayam Namami Chinmayam Devam Sadgurum Brahma Vidvaram Vasudeva Sutam Devam Kamsachanura Mardhanam Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Vande Jagadgurum Tvameva Matacha Pitatvameva Tvameva Bandusya Sakatvameva Tvameva Vijyatra Vidam Tvameva Tvameva Sarvam Mama Deva Deva Tvameva Sarvam Guru Deva Deva. Hari Om. We are doing the question and answer session. And now we ask the question that how can ignorance be basis for the projection of this whole world? So this is a question that is based on, because we said that fundamentally the mula avidya, that means the primordial ignorance, is the cause for why I become a samsari. Because I don't know who I am, and I know only partially, I know a little bit. I know I am conscious entity, I know I am existent entity, but I know I am a Brahman, or I am full by myself. Therefore I want to become full by, I want this, I want this, otherwise I am unhappy. So this is the cause for the samsara. So when I want, like things and I don't like it, vasanas bombs, and vasanas become the cause for next creation and all that. So we went through all the rigmarole, but question ultimately comes down to this pure ignorance, the muna vidya. Pure ignorance, fundamental ignorance, is for the projection of the whole universe. How does it happen? So in the example that Advaita gives is when I'm walking in the alley, I see a long and something soft, I stepped on it, and people said there are a lot of snakes there, and I saw something long and thick, 5 feet long, and it's on in the alley, and it was soft touch, and therefore I say, oh, that is a snake. And so the projection of the snake happened in the place where there is an object there. So actually, after the further investigation, we found it is a row. Now, where did the snake come from? Snake was created, even though it was a rope, but snake was created from where? Snake was created from my mind, but not created inside my mind. So there, snake is there, not in here. So I am creating a snake, so it's called vikshepa, which means creation, because I do not know that it is a rope or a snake. So I have partial knowledge. There is something there, it is 5 feet long, it is in the alley, when I stepped on it, it was soft. So these are attributes of the object there, but I don't have complete attributes, because it's not too bright or too dark. So I can see some, but not completely. So therefore, because of the partial ignorance, which is a problem, who is projecting? Is ignorance projecting? My mind is projecting because of the ignorance. Therefore, it is a snake there. So we have two things. One is avarana, covering, that means I don't know what it is, and vikshepa, projection. Avarana comes to the mind, doesn't know. The mind doesn't know that there is a rope. And vikshepa is done by the mind only, that there is a snake. So who has the ignorance? It is the mind of the fellow who doesn't know that it is a snake. And who is projecting? It is the mind only. Mind also means a product of ignorance, is a higher understanding also later. But this example says that it is the mind that is projecting. But it's the mind that has ignorance. So ignorance locus is also local mind, and projection is also by the local mind. This we have to understand. Same way, ignorance at two levels. One is the global level at the individual level. Global level we call it the Maya Shakti, and we don't call it ignorant. So the total mind projecting using that Maya Shakti, whole universe. That's in one explanation that Ishvara is creating. Temporarily, that is because let him create. But from the point of jiva also, because I don't know completely, I project something other than what it is. So that called there is a jiva srishti and Ishvara srishti. Who is projecting? Either the local mind or the global mind. And local mind and the global mind came because of ignorance is the additional aspect that we have to consider. Therefore, the ignorance generated local mind and the global mind is creating all these problems. That's why one is say ignorance is a cause, but there are two aspects. One is the avarana covering it and vichepa projectioning it. And avarana vichepa is because of not seeing completely as it is and only getting a partial knowledge. So partial attributes. So what kind of attributes I get in the world? I know world exists. So therefore existence is not a problem. But I am that existence is a problem that I don't realize it. That's where the knowledge is. So I am projecting something out as though something different from me. And for that explanation only, we bring the scriptures gives you how a dream example also occurs, where I am creating there in the dream world, whole world of objects there, both inert as well as the sentient beings, sara, achara, and at the same time, I also enter into that world. So, what is the story now? Story is, there are two srishtis. One is Isvara Srishti and a Jiva Srishti. And we need a mind. Mind, Ishvara mind that creates the global and the local mind that creates something on top of Ishvara Srishti. So if there is a beautiful something, so beautiful, that is Ishvara Srishti. Then, oh, I like this, I want this, oh, I don't like this. This likes and dislikes is on top of it, I'm projecting, and that is called Jiva Srishti. So on top of Ishvara Srishti, I'm putting likes and dislikes, quoting it, and that becomes a Ishvara, because of my vasanas. If I don't have any vasanas, then I see Ishvara Srishti only and enjoy beauty of the creation. So a Mahatma who doesn't have the vasanas, he sees the vibhuti of the Lord in everything. Whereas an individual who has not realized, because he is clouded with the vasanas, impurities of the mind, the projection also gets impure, and therefore I have this I like, that I like, and all the likes and dislikes are coming from that. So we have a avarna shakti, vichepa shakti, all attributed to the ignorance, fundamental ignorance. Also ignorance doesn't really do by itself, you need a mind, because the locus of the ignorance is also a mind. With that, we'll stop. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamiva Visishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.